Okay. Well, live.
Oh, he said he's got an introduction, too.
Okay.
Yeah, you're live.
Well, live.
I would like to welcome everyone to Freedom Hall Tabernacle Church and our annual Christmas play. We're a little late getting it on, but we have been working for the community through the Christmas season, and that is what God's children need to be doing. We are disciples of God, and when Jesus was on earth, he took his disciples and not only spread God's word, but see into needs and feeding multitudes with fish and loaves of bread. We can relate as God used a small home church to reach out to this community. Now I want to ask for your attention as we perform the final Christmas. The even the spirit of Christmas is with everyone, but do they know? Said the night wind to the little lamb, do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see? A star dancing in the night with a tail as big as the tide, with a tail as big as a kite. Send the little lamb to the shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the tree, with a voice as big as the sea, with a voice as big as the sea. Says the shepherd boy to the before Christmas Eve, and the spirit of Christmas is with everyone. But do they know the true meaning of Christmas and know that Jesus was returning one day for his children? Shopping centers full of those out looking for that last minute item, but are they looking for Jesus? This is a season where we celebrate the birth of Jesus. It should be held sacred to all. In this story, we find a grandmother son, and granddaughter are out shopping. They are all three Christians and letting their light shine for the lost to see.
All these people are making me nervous. I'm going to have a panic attack. Lord, I need your help.
We need to finish up today so we don't have to come back out.
I'm hungry.
We're going to get something on the way home.
Yep, that's it. I am looking forward to service this Sunday, Mom. It will be great singing Christmas carols with our church family.
Yes, me too. It would be great having family and church together again.
I want eggnog.
We will get some when we head home.
You don't have to buy us anything. I just want to get home and practice my songs for Sunday.
Oh. Okay, let me not put that on there. Sorry, technical difficulties. I need to find a couple more gifts, and we will be on our way. God has blessed me so much this year, and I, like you, need nothing for Christmas. I got all I need when Jesus came into my heart.
Do they sell food here? My stomach is growling.
I could eat as well.
Okay, I think I'm done. Let's try to find a short line, even though the self-checkout lines are backed up. I am not using them. They do not pay me to check myself out.
And they proceed to the checkout. The son greets cashier.
Merry Christmas, and God bless you.
Oh, happy holidays to you.
Grandmother whispers to granddaughter.
She must not believe in Jesus.
Yes, and I see there are chips and candy at the register as well. Help yourself.
Do you not believe in Christmas, or is it a company thing? I know a lot of companies doesn't allow you to say Christmas. I think it's sad. It is, of course, Jesus.
Well, the season is just a big stress. I don't even have time to think of anything in this job. It keeps me so frustrated. My heart is hardened towards the public most of the time. I don't even get to spend time with my own family at holidays.
Not even eat food?
You're 59, sir. And my feet are killing me. So many people today, and I haven't even had time to breathe.
Run it as credit, please. I will pray that things get easier and you can slow down for this season. And I will also pray that you give Jesus an opportunity to comfort you and to come into your life.
Well, on your God savings card, I need you to verify your name.
God's child.
When does it expire?
Eternity.
Okay. Here's your receipt, sir, and happy holidays. All I truly need is a day off.
Now, can we eat?
End of scene one.
Sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holidays. bustle you hear. Silver bells, silver bells. It's Christmas time in the city. Ring a ring, hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day.
Inner son, grandmother, and granddaughter. They have arrived at home and ready to wrap gifts. And continues to go by.
Mom, do you have any wrapping paper and tape that I can use to wrap these gifts?
Yes, it should be in the closet. You want me to get it?
No, I'll get it. Oh, I love this nativity scene. Wrapping paper. It will show the true meaning of Christmas.
What time is supper?
Is that all you think about? This is one of the most special seasons of all. It is the birth of our Lord, Jesus Christ. And we celebrate it even now, though that we don't know when it is.
Wow, you were right. And we have lots of candy, ham, and turkey, too.
Yes, I need to run out and get food for dinner as well. I dread dealing with those people again.
Now you're talking my language. I will go and help you.
If you go out to get dinner, we'll have to put in a layaway.
As they arrive at the grocery store and begin to shop, they hear music playing overhead.
I've used a basket.
Oh,
Skinner, son, grandmother, and granddaughter.
I really hope we have better luck this time.
Yeah, I wonder what they'd do if Jesus came back. Santa can't save them. Only the blood of Jesus can.
Will we be able to eat in heaven?
Just help us get some stuff so we can get out of here.
I think we're done now. I'm about to check out. Go and grab the Christmas cards to give out as well.
Is it okay if I get a snack?
Sure. Keep you quiet.
And possibly eggnog?
Sure.
As they proceed to the checkout, it is the same cashier from previous day.
Hello again. Merry Christmas to you and God bless.
Happy holidays. Man, you sure are chirpy.
Oh, here we go again.
We're still getting food, right?
Yes. I am a child of God. I am so happy. Are you ready for Christmas?
I'm ready for a day off. I just want to sleep.
You should really come to Sunday services with us. We will be singing Christmas carols.
And having snacks.
We'd love for you to have you join us.
Okay. $47.50 is your total. Do you have coupons?
Do I have coupons?
Oh, savings coupons. Wow! Your total is $25.27. Man, that is a great savings.
Speaking of savings, are you saved?
From what?
Hell and eternal fire below.
I guess. I'm as good as anyone who is a Christian.
It doesn't work that way. You really should come to church with us sometime. You can learn so much about Jesus, his birth, his death, and about him coming back one day soon.
Well, 73 cents is your change. Happy holidays. And come back and say, shop with Savings or Us.
And you can change too if you give your heart to Jesus.
They load up their groceries and head back home.
Hold on. Mm-mm.
No, we will. Hang on.
Hey, like we said, remember her and her baptism tonight.
This is a horrible microphone. So
roll it.
There we go. Yep.
By the way, Leslie said to remember her. She's getting baptized today. I'm on
for wonderful.
Oh, praise the Lord. Okay.
Are you ready?
Did you know that your baby boy one day walked on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy won more sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you this child that you deliver will soon deliver you? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, did you know? The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
I can't believe some people think that they are saved and don't even know what it means.
It's scary to think of. What if Jesus came back today? What would become of the non-believers? It'd be such a sad day.
Are we cooking tonight or getting something to take home?
Is eating all you think about?
Not really.
End of scene two.
Pardon
me,
we'll be back.
Yeah.
Hey, oh, there it is.
Yeah. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Oh, well, I didn't know you were going. My bad.
Hey,
look, it's a box.
Shh. Precious. My precious.
Why can you?
Wait. Shut the curtain. I hit it. That way it'll be down.
Is this moment, Lord? Okay.
Are we good?
Yes, play with
Now it is Christmas Eve. The family is sitting flipping through channels on TV.
Back in the wow, Rudolph.
Is not a...
Frosty the Snowman. The Christmas Story. Man, whatever happened to the meaning of Christmas? Jesus being in the hearts and minds of everyone. It seems that so many songs and movies that you see and hear have nothing.
So many people believe like they are mom or dad or grandmother or grandfather. It's more tradition than a true relationship with God.
People should love the Lord like we do ham, turkey, and eggnog. Not to mention pie.
The holidays is way too commercialized. People only think of themselves and getting the biggest gift or receiving the greatest gift. You know, the greatest gift was given with the birth of Jesus when he gave his life for us.
Not me. I like the food and the candy.
Oh, speaking of which, we need to lay out the turkey to thaw.
I left it out when we got home from shopping. It should be okay.
Don't let it ruin. I love turkey, dressing, pies, rolls, and...
Narrator.
Jesus should be top on that list.
Oh, okay. And shepherd's pie.
I'm tired. I think I'll go read for the night. Let's pray for the loss and for the cashier. I'm so worried about her. Love you both. I'll see you in the morning.
Yes, me too. You need to go to bed for tomorrow.
How about a blow? I will as soon as I snack.
Don't be up too long. Hey, don't get into stuff for Christmas. We will have it tomorrow.
Do you think Santa will miss a couple of his cookies?
Well, you can go ahead and eat them. If you...
In scene three.
What was that?
Everybody's laughing. Probably at the thaw.
I know I had the thaw all the time. Well, I okay. Make sure it's thaw.
We're not on live, and we're not.
We're not?
No, we are. Oh. We're just messing up and telling everything we're doing.
Yeah, there's more mics coming.
They're with us, the crackly people here.
Well, they can't see you.
Try
not to move, ready? Yeah.
Was the night before the birth of our Savior that night, the kids fast asleep as I read by my light. When my eyes got heavy, I laid my Bible down. Then I looked outside, I saw the dead rising from the ground. A loud trumpet did sound, and the kids began to scream. They didn't know if it was real or if it was just a dream. They asked if it was Santa coming that night. Then the Son of Man appeared, and the night became light. No reindeers, no sled, no man dressed in red. I saw a cloud with Jesus, this time no horns on his head. He wore a new crown this time, and he raised up his hands, then the dead that have once left this land lifted up to the cloud, floating straight in the air. Then he spoke to his children, was next to prepare. Lights that once was decoration and so very bright could not compare to the Son of Man, Jesus' very light. As I prepared to be changed in a twinkle of an eye, I couldn't help but rejoice as I began to cry. For the Son who was given so many years ago, in a manger so humble, the shepherds had told, had come back for his children, who was faithful and true. Those Hatton, I was so sorry for you. So when you go to lay down, remember this, please. If you want to go to heaven, you must pray and believe. Jesus is coming back just as he was born. So as you go through this life, listen for that horn. Jesus who died for me also died for you. If you don't receive him or give him his due, you will be sorry for hell. No one will hear your cry. There will be no phone. Prayers will be too late once he comes back. Read your Bible today. It is all the facts. This came up on my heart as I was taking my walk. Every time I go out, me and the Lord talk. He wanted you to know he loves you so dear. But time is running out, friends. Eternity is near. Bow your heads and get on your knees. Ask the Lord for forgiveness. Beg him, please. My prayer is that all would be saved. Trust in the Lord and be covered by his grace. Merry Christmas to all. And Jesus is a gift to receive, because one day we all must leave. Make heaven your home before, because hell is so real. When this life is over, your fate is sealed.
Place is empty, no more traffic in the streets. All the builders' tools are silent, no more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labors, and the cauldron of debate. Work on earth, it's all suspended as the king comes through the gate. The king is coming. The king is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. Oh, the king is coming, the king is coming. Praise God, he's coming for me. Happy faces line the hallways, those whose lives have been redeemed. Broken homes, those in prison he has freed. Little children and the aged, hand in hand stands all alone. Who are crippled, broken, ruined, clad in garments white as snow. Oh, my king is coming, the king is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. Oh, the king is coming, the king is coming. Praise God, he's coming for me. I can hear the chariots rumble. I can see the marching throng. The flurry of God's trumpet spells the end of sin and wrong. Regal roads are now unfolding. Heaven's grandstands on place. Heaven's choir is now assembled. Starts to sing amazing grace. Oh, my King is coming, the King is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. Oh, my King is coming, the King. Praise God, He's coming for me.
End of scene three. As they all slept, Jesus appeared on the cloud, and the trumpet of Gabriel sounded. Jesus had come back for his children.
What was that sound? Who would be blowing their trumpet at this time of night?
Coming back for me!
Sorry. I'm gonna eat at the welcoming table.
Praise you, Jesus! Thank you, blessed Lord. We knew you would come back soon.
They told me the truth. He is coming back tonight. And I'm ready thanks to them and their prayers.
They all appear together in the front yard looking up at the sky.
I'm so glad you came. Thanks to you, I did.
We planted the seed. It is Jesus that saves.
And we don't need coupons out there. Food's free.
Praise you, Jesus.
And they all went home to be with Jesus. The light of the Lamb outshined all the decorations that was up. Soon, all the former things of this world was no more. I ask you tonight, are you ready to go home to be with Jesus? If you are looking for the greatest gift, Jesus is that gift. We can only pray for others to receive him. And can you imagine if he come back tonight? Would you be ready to meet him? God gave his greatest gift when he sent his son down to live amongst us, to teach us, to die for us. So many things of Christmas is a reminder of Jesus. The candy cane, shaped like a J. Gifts are wrapped just like Jesus was wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. The Christmas star was a guide to bring those seeking the Messiah. And today, we need to be shining for the lost to find him. I thank him for the gift he gave us. And I have learned since becoming a Christian, the greatest gift is Jesus and the blood applied to our lives. I love you all, and I want to thank you for your attention. I just want to thank God for all he does for me and my little church. It is a blessing to serve the Lord. Now I would like to thank our members who took part in the play. We always want to shine a bright light for the world to see. Our grandmother was played by Karen Thompson. She is my mother-in-law, and I have to say, I take the in-law off because I'm treated like I am a blood child of hers. What a blessing to be able to spend my retired days with her and Jim. Love you both. The son is played by our pastor, Steve Garten. I think he gets as excited as we do to do anything the Lord puts in our hearts. If you want to see change, he would be the one to look at. Granddaughter was played by Angel Garten, my niece and sidekick. Usually if you see me, you see her. I love her to death and love spending time with her. And cashier is my wife, Angie Lowe. She worked as a cashier and loved it. We are so blessed to be with this little church family. We love to labor for the Lord, and it makes it even more rewarding when everyone works to make things happen. And I also want to recognize Christy, who has helped us with props, camera, and it's been a blessing to us in many things getting ready for this. And right now we're...
That was when we were supposed to disappear. Yeah. I've made it weird. Poof.
Our altar is open. If you want to come to the altar and give Jesus the praise he deserves. No greater gift than the gift of Jesus. He was born a virgin. He walked on this earth teaching his Father's word. He was nailed to a tree and died so that you and I could have an eternal home in heaven. Come up and pray, saint or sinner. I love you all and so thankful for your attention. And if you are searching for the Lord, be glad to pray with you and for you.
Lisa said amazing job, guys. Lisa.
And you don't even have to be here to go to the altar. Just kneel where you're at right now. If something we said led you to do that, then do that where you're sitting right now watching us. If you feel like you need to rededicate your life to the Lord, the altar's open. If you feel like you just need to pray to get something off you and give it to God and lay it at his feet because you can't take it any longer, open.
You don't have to change. God can change you. Jesus can come and change you like that. Your choice. He never sent you to hell. He gave you the choice, heaven or hell. You make the choice today.
You don't have to be a sinner to go to the altar. Sometimes you just want that closer walk with God. That's what rededication is. You just want that closer walk. You know what your plan is for God. Maybe you're going through something and you just can't handle it anymore and it's bringing you down mentally. Your depression, your anxiety. Lay it at the altar. Give it at Jesus' feet. Struggling with something, and whether it's financial, whether it's relationships,
if you happen to be drinking or on drugs, don't change for Christ. He will change you. He'll come into your life and make you a new person.
Never be ready.
If there's something weighing on your heart that you know that if you walk out of here, maybe you're not as close to God as you should be, or you want to be, just come and kneel down and tell him you want that strength, you want that knowledge, you want that peace within yourself to be able to follow him closer and know, have the knowledge of his word more.
Child is this who learned to rest on Mary's lap asleep.
Lisa and Rose said heal. Lisa and Rose said heal. Lisa and Rose said heal. He was talking.
We have a couple of people online that had things to give to the Lord.
You know, we see Christmas with trees and presents. Has to do with that child, that God, who manifested in the flesh. And there's only one purpose, to teach us how to live and to die. Otherwise, we'd be having sacrifices to this day. If you don't know this man, he is Jesus Christ. And you can know him tonight. We got people surrounding the altar. If you don't want to come alone, you're not alone. We will be here. And we'll pray over you.
If you're in the other room and you have a deuce peg, they'll stand and get out of your way. You want somebody to go to the altar with you? Grab somebody's hand, go to the altar with them. They'll pray with you. You know what you need to talk to God about. We'll just pray that He gives you the strength to get through what you're going through. Each and every one of us are sinful. As long as we're in this flesh, we are sinful. We just have to rely on God to get through it. Your best relationship ever is a relationship with God. That's the most personal, closest relationship you could ever have in your life. Break out and preach, so I need to hush. There's somebody that's not minding God. Somebody needs to, either it's a rededication, it's delayed something that's on them. Nobody will laugh at you. Nobody will stare at you. Everybody will support you and surround you. You just have to make that trip. Our deacon has come up, so see, you don't. It don't matter how long you've been a Christian. Sometimes you just need to lay stuff down. Sometimes you need to get that closer relationship. Finances, relationships, children, family, exes, laid at God's feet.
You know, girlfriend and boyfriend and husband and wife can leave you. Christ will never leave you.
You all continue praying. I have a reading from Luke 2. I do not have the scripture, so you'll have to listen. I thought about putting it up here, but that was a lot. And it came to pass in those days that there were... Okay, yep, that ain't even the word. They went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenus was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of the lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, about them. And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was an was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go unto them, unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And this came with haste, and found Mary, and Joseph, and the babe lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they had known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, and it was told unto them. And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived in the womb. And when the days were of his purification according to the law of Moses were accomplished, they brought him to Jerusalem and presented him to the Lord.
Amen.
Before Ron says his word, is there anybody else who feels the draw to come to the altar? There's both sides of the altar. You don't have to wait for somebody to get up. You don't even have to go to the altar. It's kneel on the floor.
You need anyone to go up with you.
Yep. Anybody go with you, just pick them. Grab their hand. They'll follow you.
Yep. Or just look at them and nod at them. Mm-hmm.
While he's praying, I'd like to thank everybody that's joining. We thank Ron so much for coming up with these plays. We thank Steve for stepping down, which is a hard thing if you're a leader to do, but, you know, he felt it on him to step down. We thank you for Angie and Christy and Angel, and we thank you all, even the audience out here.
Especially for someone who has to be in control of things. But, you know what it's taught me? You know, we're in order to serve Christ, we have to surrender. Jesus gave the biggest example that us leaders must humble and to serve. And since Angie and Ron had come to church and I've given them things that I was in control of, man, I know why he says to do it. Because it is great to surrender to people. And it's great to have trust in people who've done such a wonderful job. And we're not done yet. But I felt that on me. But I'll just shut up.
And for me, one that can't hardly stand up by themselves and do something, much less sing a cappella with a song. When God asks you to do something, do it. You know, because you'll sleep good that night. And if I could have said, no, I don't want in this play. I don't want this part. But I can't do that, you know, because he did everything for me. I've got to do something little for him if it's this.
I want to say, with the help of the Lord, there is no way I could ever do anything without him to revelate my mind and help me write out these plays. I sometimes wonder through my writing how the apostles must have felt as they told of their lives in the scriptures. It is a blessing to have the Lord in your life and to reveal himself through you and your plays, acting, preaching, singing, and most importantly, our actions as We are out amongst lust. Our lights need to be bright, church. It is dark world and getting darker. Satan is in the churches and getting stronger by the day. He is deceiving so many, but we know how it is all going to end. Don't be deceived. Be faithful until the end and make heaven our home. What a blessing it would be to look out here tonight and see Jesus coming on a cloud. Can you imagine the rejoicing that would go over this house if we heard the trumpet sound tonight? We're going to reap our reward. I'm going to give mine unto the Lord, because without Him, I'm nothing. I sure don't feel worth much in this old body of pain. I can't do the things I once physically could do, but He has given me a spiritual mind, and now I can do and touch ones I never touched before. Thank you all for coming, and thank you for listening. I hope and pray if you are not ready to meet the Lord tonight, you make it right before you leave here tonight. We none know the hour of the day. He could come tonight. I am ready to go and not going to let anyone or anything keep me from going. God bless you, and I'm so glad I'm a child of the King. Brother Steve.
You know, Christmas is about family. It's about love. It's about giving. It's about reminding people the hope and the goodness of humanity. You know, we saw that with this love walk. We were blessed to take care of families, to be a part of that. It makes me so happy when I talk about it. It tears me up, because we have a church that isn't afraid to get out there and say, we're small, but we're going to make a big impact. However, it is first, foremost, and mainly about celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ, our Savior. No, He was not born in December. The shepherds do not tend to their flocks in the winter. It's believed around September 13th to 15th is the actual date of His birth. Why it is at December 25th, I don't know. But it is really not His birthday on that day. However, God became a man, Emmanuel, translated in from the Hebrew, God with us. Jesus is the ultimate gift. If you've not opened that gift, make sure that the most important gift is opened right now. Christmas means two words, Christ Mass. It means the Christ celebration. Before I close this out, and I did not hit that. Before I close this out, I want to thank my brother. He ain't my brother-in-law, he's my brother, for having me be a part of this. I thank Angie for, you know, being a part of this and for helping him and for doing what they've done since they've been here. And I thank the actors. It was fun. You know, I was waiting on it. I'm going to go ahead and reveal it now. Every time we would rehearse, there's a part the mom couldn't say the word people.
People. People.
Every time. Yeah. So my part after her is people. Now, you all have seen movies where these people go out of their mind and they start talking to themselves. Well, that was her. She goes, he can say it. Why can't I say it? He can say it. He can say it without a problem. What's my problem? I can't say it. And I lost it.
That was practice.
So I was waiting for that to happen. But I thank everybody who watched and tuned in. And I want to tell you all, we are tuning out. But we have to set up the church. We're going to break out the props. Watch for our notifications to come back. We are having praise and worship. Service is not done, but we have to come off camera. Thank you, Christy, for helping. God bless everybody. I love you. And I'll see you all here in a few.